Kidney problem is very common nowadays. Kidney urinary infection, kidney failure, stones in the kidney, urinary infection, burning sensation in the urinary tract, all common problem in case of both men and women. How kidneys are affected? Kidneys are the source of energy for us. Kidney is not producing urine alone. It actually conserves the energy, sends it back to the heart. Then from the heart, the circulation occurs through every part of the body. But only thing is, what is not required is being eliminated through the kidney in the form of urine. But what is to be retained in the form of source of energy is sent back to the heart. So this is the center for elimination and also for reserving the source of energy. But only thing is, you have to retain the kidneys. There are two kidneys. Even if one doesn't function properly, other actually compensates. Compensatory mechanism is always. But how the kidneys are affected? Nowadays it has become a common affair. Kidney problem is always there for most of the people. How the kidneys are affected? Because we are overloading our body, our digestive system, with so many medicines. Medicines are chemicals. Our body is made up of only energy, not with the chemicals. So our body needs lot of energy. That energy comes from the food which we are taking. So the digestive system is very important. Digestion takes place by this structure called, or organs called, stomach, small intestine. Assimilation is there by through the small intestine, etc. But only thing is, this has to be preserved properly. But we are taking, in addition to the food, we are taking also medicines. Medicines are chemicals. This actually goes to the liver, which is the detoxifying agent. If it is overloaded, then the ball is in the court of kidney. Then the liver says, I cannot manage the overloading of the stomach chemicals, you take care. Then kidneys are overstrained. Then overstressing the kidney with the chemicals actually causes damage to the nephrons, which are the functional unit of the kidney. Once the nephrons are affected, there are millions of nephrons present in the kidney, but once the nephrons are affected, some nephrons are functioning, some more nephrons are not functioning. So the total loss is not there. That is why the patient is able to pass urine. But only thing is, there is total loss, he will not be able to pass urine at all. That compensatory mechanism is there, repairing mechanism also is there. To some extent, it is able to maintain properly. If the at this stage, if the patient goes to the doctor and says the urine is not coming out in proper quantity, and then if he goes to the diagnosis, then the doctor says you have got creatinine level high, sodium level is high, urea level is high, all these things they are telling. Then how to repair the kidney? Kidneys are connected to the Muladhara Chakra. Muladhara Chakra is responsible for the function of the kidney. To some extent, kidneys can manage. If you go on stress, overstressing the kidney, at particular stage it will stop functioning. That is how the urea level, creatinine level. We are not diagnosing the kidney function by diagnosing the urea level, kidney, creatinine level, etc. We go to the Muladhara Chakra. The moment a person comes with a kidney failure, we go to the Muladhara Chakra, then go to the, through the Swadhisthana Chakra, we go to the Back Manipura Chakra. Why Back Manipura Chakra? Because the kidneys are present in the retroperitoneal part of the body, in the back of the lumbar region. We go to the Back Manipura Chakra by treating the kidney which are present there. Back Manipura Chakra, Muladhara Chakra, through the Back Manipura Chakra we go to the Agni Chakra. Agni Chakra, Back Manipura Chakra, Muladhara Chakra, these are the source of energy to the kidneys. We treat the kidney problem by going to the three chakras like this. In case of kidney stones also, we take these three chakras only. Reiki actually is responsible for channelizing the cosmic energy into the corresponding organ. We go through Reiki, we go to the chakras. Then the acupuncture. In Sudoku acupuncture, kidneys are represented in the exactly mid part of the palm. These are the two kidneys which are represented here. We try to find out where the problem is present. Identify the point, then we apply the needle. In case the patient doesn't want acupuncture, we apply pressure here. By applying mere pressure for both the kidneys, kidneys recover. But kidneys are not independent of the brain. We go to the brain. Hypothalamus is the structure, which is part of the brain, which is having control over the kidneys. We go to the kidneys and also brain. So through Sudoku acupuncture, we treat the brain and also the kidneys. In case of kidney problem, usually there will be blood pressure. So we treat the blood pressure by going to the adrenal gland. Treat the brain, treat the kidneys, and also to get rid of the blood pressure, you treat the adrenal glands. This is how you treat. In case of kidney stone, again you apply the pressure here. Kidney meridian is present here. Kidney, in case of kidney problem, kidney failure, maybe it is dry. Dryness has to, kidney meridian, the dryness point has to be radiated, or coldness point. You have to choose the corresponding point. Then choose the point and apply the needle by sedating the particular element. In case of kidney stone, you sedate the coldness point. The meridian is running like this. You sedate the coldness point by applying needle like this. The other problem involving the urinary system, urinary bladder. Bladder is in the lower part of the abdomen. Usually people come with a complaint of urinary tract infection. Burning sensation is there while passing urine. I am not able to pass urine, or there will be pain in the case of while passing urine. All these things are the symptoms of the problem. So while passing the urine, if there is burning sensation, or always burning sensation in the urinary bladder area, go to the chakra. This is the Swadhisthana chakra, which has got control over the bladder and urethra. So channelize the energy by going through the Swadhisthana chakra and Mooladhara chakra. Swadhisthana chakra and Mooladhara chakra, they are not independent of each other. So treat these two chakras. Then in case of urinary bladder problem, bladder is present here. You apply pressure here like this. For Mooladhara chakra, you apply pressure here. In between the two knuckles, you can apply pressure. That is how you treat bladder infection.